Hello everybody, my name is Ayman Frika. I'm a field software engineer at Canonical. Today, I will show you a demo about one of my favorite AI ML tools, which is Kale. Kale simplifies the AI developer's workflow by giving data scientists the tool they need to orchestrate end-to-end machine learning workflows through Kubeflow. Using Kale and Kubeflow, the developer workflow can be summarized by this picture. Basically, a data scientist needs to access Kubeflow to create an account where he will have access to the greatest AI ML tools like JupyterHub to develop the AI algorithm, KATIP for hyperparameter tuning, as well as Kubeflow pipelines. First of all, in this platform, a developer will create a notebook with the right resources in terms of memory, CPU, and GPU capabilities. This notebook will allow the data scientist to easily create, test, and optimize the AI algorithm. It has the necessary libraries like TensorFlow and PyTorch, but also allows you to download and use any other libraries. After iterating over the algorithm and testing, the developer can use Kale to split the source code into multiple steps that will run independently into the pipeline. The data scientist can also iterate over the creation of an efficient pipeline that can be reused multiple times to finally create the ultimate model that can maybe push into production and serve real requests or predict real events. In this demo, we will use this environment that is composed of an Elasticsearch cluster that will be used as a data store, a Ceph cluster that is used as an object storage to store the result model, a Kubeflow environment that is used as a data scientist platform to develop the AI algorithm as well as run the pipeline. All those environments are deployed on top of virtual machine on AWS. We can see here that all those environments are managed and deployed using the same tool, which is Juju. Either they are deployed on top of Kubernetes or not. Let's take a look at what has been deployed on this environment. We can see here that we have a data store model. So here we have a data store model that is composed of a cluster of Elasticsearch. This is where we have the training data. We also have another model, which is Ceph model. So in the Ceph model, we have the Ceph cluster where we have the object storage component of Ceph, which is Ceph Redis Gateway. And the Ceph cluster will be used to store the result model that will be trained by Kubeflow. We also have another model, but it's on top of another controller, which is Microcase. So Juju controllers, let's switch to the microcontroller. And here we can see another environment, which is a Kubeflow environment with all its components. Basically, this environment is deployed on top of Microcase. To be able to use the Kale image inside our Kubeflow cluster, we need to store it in a registry. This can be a local registry or a remote one. We can use Docker Hub if you want. In this demo, we will use the Microcase add-on for the registry, which will create a local registry inside Microcase. Let's enable this add-on. So we need to execute microcase.enable per registry. It might take some time, so we may accelerate things. The registry add-on is finished executing. So now the registry is built in within microcase. Now we need to download Kale. Here, let's take the Kale command. All right, there is it. So we need to download Kale from GitHub. Then we need to build the Jupyter Sorry about that. Yeah, we need to build the Jupyter Docker file, the Jupyter Love Docker file. Let's do that. All right, so we don't have the Docker command. So let's install the Docker snap here. So now Docker is installed and we need to attach it to our local registry here. Okay. Okay, let's do that. Seems that this command doesn't work. Now we can restart the Docker service. So let's build the Docker file that we talked about. We can do it with this command. So this will take a little bit of time. So yeah, let's accelerate that in this. This demo. The build of our Docker registry, of our Docker image, sorry, is finished for Kale. Now we will push it to our local registry. Let's push it now with this command. All right, so, okay, has been disconnected. This will also take some moment. We will accelerate that for this demo. Okay, now our Docker image is pushed to our registry. It's finished. We can verify that by executing this command, sudo docker images. So we can see it here. Sorry, we can see it here that it's stored in our local registry. So let's now use it with the Jupyter Hub notebook inside Kubeflow. By default, when we access Jupyter Hub notebook after an initial deployment of the environment, we get this list of available notebooks. But since we will not use those notebooks and we use Kale notebook that has been built earlier, we will use custom image here and we will put the Kale URL. So let's use that. Let's put the Kale URL, Kale demo, and we need to change this notebook resources. We will put one CPU, 2 GB of RAM. This demo will not be run on GPU. And then we need to hit launch. So the creation of this notebook will take some time. So also we'll accelerate that in this demo. Now we have our Jupyter notebook deployed and running correctly. We can now access it. We already downloaded some notebooks file in this image. So those are the notebooks. Let's start by this notebook. Basically, we can find some Python code that is responsible to download data from Elasticsearch, train it, and deploy the model result into Ceph object storage packet. We will not go into the details of this code in this demo since our main purpose here is the Kale usage. So here, let's enable Kale. So basically, when we enable it, we can find that there is an edit button appeared in the top corner of each cell. So when we click on it, there is a new parameters that appear. Basically, those are some metadata field that Kale used to be able to identify the purpose of each block and put it on the right step when it builds the pipeline. Here, for example, it's obvious that it's an import step. We can put it as import here. And Kale can identify it as an import and put it on the right step. Here, for example, this is a function that will be used by all the steps. So here we can put it as a function. Let's see, for example, here. All right, where is it? There is parameter step. Yeah, this one. This is a parameter pipeline step that we can identify it as a pipeline parameters. So Kale will be able to put it as parameter for all the steps that will be run. So we already created another notebook that has all those steps already filled. So we can see here the function steps, the pipeline parameters, and also the main steps that will be deployed, like the pre-process, the train, and the deploy steps, which will deploy the result model into a bucket here. So let's run it. Here, so we'll put the pipeline name, which is financial time series. We will use the default experiment. And here we use this Docker image, which is Kale demo. So let's compile and run this Kale demo. So first of all, it will validate it, compile it, upload the pipeline, and run the pipeline. So let's go here and see what's going on. This will take some time, but basically we see our pipeline is deployed. So since it's taking some time, we will accelerate it for this step. Now our pipeline run finished successfully. As we can see, here are the main steps for this pipeline, for pre-process, train, and deploy. We can also check the logs and the details of each steps. So here are the logs for training. Like here, we achieved 0.72 accuracy. The details of each step, as well as the input-output parameters for it, like the endpoint URL, the bucket, and so on and so forth. Thank you for watching this demo. It has been a pleasure. See you in the next demo.